Defects in crystals are small imperfections on the atomic scale that can severely impact the material's properties already at the tiniest concentrations. Deep-level transient spectroscopy, or DLTS for short, is a method that we use to detect these defects in semiconducting materials. It measures the thermal emission of charge carriers trapped in defect states in a semiconductor's bandgap. The emission process contains information on certain properties of defects, such as their position in the bandgap and their capture cross-section for charge carriers. These are fingerprints of the defects that can then be used to reveal a defect's microscopic origin. DLTS is an extremely sensitive technique. It can detect defects with concentrations down to 0.1% of the density of free carriers. In order for DLTS to work on a material, a special type of contact has to be applied to it, a so-called rectifying contact, which in most cases is a suitable metal deposited on top of the semiconductor, called Schottky contact or Schottky diode. By applying a voltage to the diode, we can force the defects to change their charge state. In conventional DLTS, we keep the diode under a reverse bias and apply short forward pulses to it to fill the defects with charge carriers before reverting to reverse bias. We then measure the electrical capacitance of the diode in dependence of time as the carriers are being re-emitted. The emission process is extremely sensitive to temperature, so changing the temperature during the measurement will activate defect levels located at different positions in the bandgap. In the end, this method will give you an overview of what kind of defects you have in a material and how much of them. The sample under study is mounted on a sample stage, which is connected to ground potential. The diode itself is contacted with a needle to which the bias is being applied. Usually the sample stage is placed in a cryostat and under vacuum. For cooling, different methods are in use for different setups. Some use liquid nitrogen, which makes temperatures to 77 Kelvin possible. Others use closed cycle helium refrigerator systems to achieve temperatures down to 20 Kelvin. We also have a high temperature setup in which temperatures of up to 700 Kelvin can be achieved, which is important for studying semiconductors with wide bandgaps such as gallium oxide, where defects can be located very deep in the bandgap. The temperature is being measured and adjusted by a lakeshore temperature controller with resistive heaters connected to it. Electrical measurements are done by high precision capacitance meters. The reverse bias and short voltage pulses for trap filling are supplied by a pulse generator. We use DLTS a lot for finding and identifying defects in semiconductors such as gallium oxide or silicon carbide, which are important materials for power electronics, for example. In these technologies, control over defect populations is vital, because even the smallest amount of defects can determine if a device works or not. We combine DLTS with computational ab initio methods that model defect properties. This enables us to assign experimental signatures to specific defects, making microscopic identification possible.